Well, normally my approach is start asking questions, get to know you, but I get the impression from winning a contest, you're sort of more an inventor type, you know, and less, maybe less the entrepreneur. I don't know.
Actually, I also have been actually leading a business plan competition for a year.
Oh my gosh. Yeah, so. Oh gosh. You got all, you're going to be everyone in one person.
But I mean, kind of like the trouble I have is I'm the jack of all trades kind of thing. So do we have to specialize in something to be really good at it in order to take it to the next level?
Well, I don't know. I always found that, well, kind of excelled in one area, but I tried to do all the little aspects involved in doing it, which was digital design for computers. Hmm. So I would apply that to your case. It's like, you say you're an inventor, that means you sit down and you build real practical things. They work, you turn something, some effect, when it's done, is it hardware or software?
Mostly hardware.
Mostly hardware.
Mechanical.
Wow, oh my God, I wish I were in your shoes. I wish I were in college right now. The funnest time in the world when you can build these devices, you know, and say, oh my gosh, I made it myself. Whether it's useful or not, it's interesting.
Yeah.
Inventors, in my opinion, I've met a lot of them through time, and they're sort of independent. They kind of come up with their ideas, and they're so far ahead of the rest of the world in what they're doing that it's hard to give advice. You know, it's pretty much they know what they're doing and they know how. Certainly, try to know the value of it. Know what's in your heart. You know, do you like to build things that you think have value to the world or that have value to yourself?
I think I would like to build stuff value for the world, which is why I try to like stay away from. I kind of have the notion that, you know, making money is probably not such a great thing.
What's the most fun about it? Do you ever have late nights, and then something's not working yet?
Yeah, something's not working yet, and if you promise, like, you'll show somebody, you know, hey, I'll show this cool stuff tomorrow, and you know, it'll be there, and like, oh no, it doesn't really work now, and then what am I gonna do about it? And, sort of stay up.
And then you finally get it working. How does
try
it feel?
To figure it out. It somehow always works out. It's very stressful, but it always works out. You said being independent and things like that as related to the traits of being an inventor, right? But to work, you know, in a collective manner, and the things we're discussing over in this conference about collective intelligence and things like that, you have to work with other people, right? So do you like, how would you suggest you could try to work with having independent trade, well, with working other people as well?
Well, first of all, you start off, very often the best things you do, you've never done before. It's your first time. You're taking bits of knowledge that you have. How do you make this certain thing? That's what I'm guessing, that's how it is for you. Well, in that case, anybody that you talk to is giving you inspiration, ideas. Here's how I did something once. Here's what you might try, you know, and get your thinking going. Get your thinking blood going. A couple of things that I really want you to invent for me. I want you to invent a normal 2D display, like a liquid crystal display, but it's also 3D. No extra cost. And I don't have to wear glasses. I want you to play with optical illusion tricks and left and right lights. And I want you to make a machine that can make a cup of coffee. Think that's possible?
Machine can make a cup of coffee?
Machine makes a cup of coffee. You could go into my house,
yeah,
right? And you could probably make a cup of coffee.
Yeah.
And I could go into your house and I might be able to make a cup of coffee. I might not understand your coffee maker. But could you build a machine that could walk into a house and maybe make a cup of coffee?
Yeah, definitely.
What are some of the steps it would have to do?
Make a cup of coffee and walk in the house.
Wouldn't it have to have vision?
Yeah, it's got to have vision.
And have to walk?
First of all, yeah, it's got to be able to move in some manner across staircases, all the kind of different terrain that normally our 2 feet can bring us over.
And what would it have to find?
It would have to come in.
Yeah, come in the house, right?
Yeah, come in the house. You've got to find like where's the location of the place.
And I'll let you in the front door.
Yeah, so we've got to know that's the front door. I mean, you must recognize that that's the front door. We know it's the front door because you've gone through life.
You're in my house now. What are you going to do to make a cup of coffee?
So in your house, we've got to find out where the kitchen is.
Yes.
Correct.
So. Yes, and you do that by vision.
Vision, yeah.
You can know what a kitchen is. How do you know what a kitchen is?
Well, you kind of see where all the plumbing sort of leads to generally. I mean, I don't know, you can have floor plan in the house maybe.
So you know what a kitchen is because you learned it.
Yeah, learn it. So generally, if you know,
did the robot learn it? Does it live for years?
You can teach it if there's like there's a sink over there and there's a stove and maybe a microwave oven. That is probably a kitchen. I mean,
That's not bad.
It's an assumption you're making over here, but these are simplifying assumptions we make.
Oh, good. Now the robot is smarter than us. It doesn't have to learn it.
Yeah,
it knows it. So, and then how does it find a coffee maker?
Either it can make its own coffee using its own machine, or if it wants to find
That's not what I'm talking about. I want to use my machine.
So use your machine. Alright, so you got to have all the different models of coffee makers available out there. Okay. Have all the instruction manuals somehow coded inside how you use those things.
He solved the problem. I've been thinking it had to learn how to open up drawers and read labels and try to find filters. And he's got it. He just pre-programmed it for everyone out there.
So, yeah.
I think that's a good solution.
Thank you.
You passed.